What you're about to see now is a compilation of videos made by students like you. An homage to pop culture, current events, and anything else that we may find that will entertain you. And of course, give us plenty of views and subscribers. Hi, my name is Robert, and this is What Is Good at BHHS.
What's good?
What's good?
What's good?
What's good?
What's good at BHHS? Call me!
Now, I'm the host of the show now, and watching a few episodes, I've noticed something that this show is missing: an educational purpose. So I am here today to give the show an educational purpose and teach you a little something, a little history lesson, so to speak. What is it going to be about? Well, roll the title cards, and I will be right back.
Like most stories, it all started with one man. No, not that man. Not that man either. Who put that in there? If I find a person that made this video, I swear. Oh, there we go. This is Stephen Hindenburg, born back in August 21st, 1961, in Fort Sill, Oklahoma. Before working in the cartoon industry, one of Hindenburg's earlier jobs was being a marine biologist. You know, like Aquaman, but cooler. While he did enjoy his time sleeping with the fishes, in a good way, of course, he also found interest in the arts world when he was asked to make a comic teaching about marine biology. The Intertidal Zone, featuring a character named Bob the Sponge. It couldn't get any more obvious than that. He eventually decided to quit his old job in order to start a new career in the animation industry. He was later hired by Nickelodeon Studios to start his first professional job, being the director of the animated show Rocko's Modern Life. And although it was a successful show, it wouldn't be his most remembered project. After recalling his old days of being a marine biologist, Hindenburg had an idea for a show that would change Nickelodeon forever, a show which would be entitled Sponge Boy Ahoy! The name was eventually changed, and on May 1st of 1999, after the Kids' Choice Awards, kids all over the world were asked the most important question: were they ready? Kids. It's safe to say that they were, since from the very beginning, people loved the depiction of the underwater world, and the show's funny, compelling, colorful, and most importantly, profitable characters. To say that the show became a cultural phenomenon is a major understatement, since it spawned several pieces of merchandise, feature films, memes. Oh, and did I mention merchandise? The show officially became Nickelodeon's cash cow, and is to this day their most popular program. Although the show is going great and is currently on its 12th season, the people at Nickelodeon knew that some bad news was eventually going to come. On November 26th of 2018, Stephen Hindenburg sadly passed away due to heart failure. This news made people who were fans of the show from the very beginning so heartbroken that they knew they had to do something in honor of the man that shaped their childhoods. So during the halftime show of the 53rd Super Bowl, fans were presented with a heartwarming tribute to the man in the form of a song that was made famous by the show, Sweet Victory. Sweet Victory. I'm sorry for laughing, it's just, why would the NFL care about SpongeBob? I was lying, by the way, about the whole Sweet Victory. I was lying, yeah. The NFL decided not to perform Sweet Victory, and instead, they gave us sicko mode. Yeah, instead of giving a tribute to a man that had just died and revolutionized cartoons forever, they gave us sicko mode. If I find a person that was responsible for deciding that, hey, that's a good idea. Yes, this man just died. You know, let's perform a sicko mode. If I find a person that decided to make that decision, I'm going to find him personally, and I am going to...
Sorry I had to see that, everyone. It's just, you know, Super Bowl and SpongeBob and... why did they have to be trees like... That's in the past now. But you know what else is in the past? Xbox! We now take you to whoever is speaking in this next video to tell you about the evolution of the Xbox.
For the first time, let me now unveil Xbox.
Yes, the Xbox. It's not an X, it's a box. So why do they call it that? Well, the show's almost over. I know, you're all sad, I know. It means no more me, right? No, you'll see me in later episodes. But for right now, we have some footage exclusive, what's good only, of Braddock Hills versus Andrew Street, the fight of the century. Roll the footage.
Attention, please. If dancing is not your thing, please step aside.
Are you ready? Hey. Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready?
Oh.
Whole squad ready?
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready. We came here to see Jeff. What you got?
No.
Not on my watch.
No way.
Bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Hey.
You can bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Woo.
Bring what you got. Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. I'm going to the top.
Into the beat. 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 Into the
needed some shit with some bobbin. Let's go. I flew past the whip with that blunt in my mouth, watch the swerve and that whip had a cop in it. My pussy fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shit.
When I get to hopping, of course, I keep it true. That's not a reliable source. So tell me, have you seen her? Let me wrap my weave up. I'm the trap Selena. Tell me my gasoline.
And what an epic battle that was. Well, that pretty much concludes our show for today. Remember to like this video, maybe subscribe, maybe ring the bell. But anyways, thank you for watching, and I will hopefully see you next time.